variable fonts just got superpowers in After Effects beta. Now you can animate, weight, width, slant, and much more directly in the timeline, plus fine-tune everything in the properties panel. Now I already created two tutorials on this topic, but now that we finally have native text animators support, it is time to explore the way it was always meant to work. Better late than never. So just in case you don't know, a variable font is a single typeface that contains multiple styles, so you can smoothly adjust things like weight, width, and slant without switching fonts. One place to find those fonts is Google Fonts, of course, but this will show you dozens, if not hundreds, thousands of families, so I highly recommend to filter them using the word vary. It should be enough to select technology variable, and this is going to show you all the options. Now, of course, you need to go inside, and then you need to decide if you want to use them. You can see how many axes there are, and just download and install the font, and it should be available in all of the applications. Another way to work is, of course, to use Creative Cloud. If you have membership for After Effects, you also get somewhere around 20,000 fonts. So from the Creative Cloud app, just click on Fonts and then click on Browse More Fonts. This is going to open up the Adobe Fonts, where you can just filter variable fonts. And there you have something around 30 pages at the time of this recording. And each one of them will show you different options. Here are a few of my favorites. You can read the name over here and you can play with this so you can get a sense of how this works. And now we can, of course, animate these things inside After Effects. I'll show you in a moment. But here are a few other examples to consider. Maybe this one as well. I really like their roundness over here. Notice that we can go from very thin to very wide. And of course, this one. And sometimes you'll see that you have more than just one axis. For example, this nickel gothic variable, which is one of my favorite, you can see that you can also animate the slant. And by animate, of course, first you need to choose what you want to use. And then if you want, you can apply text animators. Now let me show you how this works inside After Effects. But before doing so, let's quickly visit this website, coolors.co, links for everything I'm showing you under the like button. I'll click on start the generator, and every time I hit spacebar, I'll get a new color scheme, which I can then, if I like, just export to my favorite application, or I'm going to just snapshot it. So I'm just going to grab a screenshot and I'll save it. So I'll switch to After Effects now and I'll import the file that I've created so we can sample some colors from it. I'll create a new composition. I'll name it text. I happen to know that those values are going to work fine in this example. So 550 for the width, 190 for the height. It doesn't really matter. You can go your own way. Duration is set to 5 seconds. And let's just grab this purple color for the background and click OK. Next, I'll double click on the T in order to create a text. And because this is November, I'm going to say 50%. I want to give you 50% discount just because I love you. What I want to sell you? Nothing, just knowledge. So basically it's free, so 100%. But we are going to go with 50%. I'll reselect the color scheme so I can see them, and then I'll head to the text in the properties panel and start to type the word vary in order to see all of my variable fonts. Now, this list is going to look different on your machine depending on the fonts that you synced or installed. But if I'll just start to scroll down until I find something that may work in this case, I'm looking for some really wide one just to demonstrate. As always, we can select from different weight, but we can also click on this new button. So this font has two axes. Now, depending on the font that you're going to use, you may see more than two or maybe just one. And this is what you can animate. So just in case you want to follow along, I'm actually going to use this nickel gothic variable and make sure it is centered in the middle of the comp. I'm also going to click over here and show you that in this case, we can animate the width as well as, so let's start with 100, just so we can see it properly on screen. And then of course the slant. All right, I don't think I want to animate the slant. I'm just going to reset it and head back to the timeline and select just the first two digits, so 50. Now I'll open up the text options in the timeline, and under animate, we have a new option to add variable font axis. So I'll start with the width, and because I only selected these two characters, After Effects automatically set the range selector for me. So you can see the start and the end are looking like this. And this means that I can start, let's say, with a value of 25 at the start, create a keyframe, go, let's say, 1 second, and then change it back to 100. And I'm going to copy this keyframe, go to 2 seconds and paste it, and then click on the font axis with words, which is going to select all three keyframes. Press F9 to easy ease them, and I can preview what I have. All right, wonderful. I'm also going to go to the Add menu and add a fill color. And remember, because we are working just with this area, I'm actually selecting those two digits. So maybe let's go with this color. No, I think we are going to try something a little bit more obvious. All right, so this one. All right, now I'm going to name this one 50, and then press Command D to duplicate it and change the name to a percentage. And all I need to do in this case is open up the range selector, open up the advanced, and change the mode from add to subtract. So in this case, I'm actually selecting the opposite. Now, just so we can see what we are doing, let's pick a different color. And we also want to flip those keyframes. So I'll go to the beginning, and I'm actually going to delete this keyframe and then marquee around those two and bring them over, and then go over here, select this one, copy and paste it. And with any luck, this is what I've created. Wow, so cool. Now, of course, at any point, I can go over here and say, well, you know what? Maybe I want more than 50%, maybe 140 for the font axis. And in this case, I can also go a little bit wider, so maybe 125 for both of them. And I'm also going to option click on the stopwatch and type in loop out. So we are going to loop those three keyframes for both of them. And now if I'll preview it, it's just going to continue until the end of the comp. And this used to be so difficult to achieve in previous versions of After Effects. Now let's take it a bit further. I'll create a new composition. This time I'm going to create a full HD comp, and then I'll bring this one over here. I'll go to Effects and Presets and add the CC Repetile effect to this composition. And I'll change both expand right and expand left to 1500. And then I'll duplicate this layer, bring it down, and move it somewhere like this. And now I can create an adjustment layer and another instance of the repetile effect. This one wants to do the up and down number. So I'm just going to duplicate it up and down. And I may need to change the spacing between them, so they're going to look nice. And now all I need to do is find the loop point. So let's start from here, frame 13. I'll press B to set the beginning of the working area. And then I'll move to, I think, over here. This looks to me like a good looping point, and set the end area. And now let's preview it, and with any luck, we'll have a seamless loop. Well, almost. I think I need maybe another frame. Let's test it again. Yes, now it's perfect. So this is just one simple example of what you can do with variable fonts inside After Effects. For more ideas and different approaches, check out my earlier tutorials on the topic. Links are down below. And if you want a mega boost of motion graphics techniques you never knew were legal, have a look at my School of Motion course, After Effects Insider. If you grab it on time, there is a great Black Friday deal, so you can enjoy not 50% discount, but something really, really cool. And now, go treat yourself to something you absolutely don't need. You earned it.